Clinical chemistry is one of the areas in the clinical pathology laboratory, which includes microbiology and hematology. In this course, we cover clinical chemistry, special chemistry, toxicology, urine analysis, and blood gas analysis in adults, pediatrics, and geriatric patients. Generally, those taking this course are interested in a career in a clinical laboratory and therefore want to become a clinical laboratory scientist. Some students take this course to learn more about the role of a clinical laboratory in healthcare, to apply for medical or pharmacy school. Others may be taking this course for personal interest or to support other more specialized programs. So no matter which career choice you may have, there are many different touch points that involve the laboratory testing process to serve our patients and support patient care. A main part of this course will cover human physiology to understand the underlying disease processes that ultimately lead to the testing that is being performed in the laboratory. In our course, we cover the entire testing process from the pre-analytical to the analytical to the post-analytical phase. As part of the pre-analytical phase, we cover everything from which tests should be ordered to answer a particular clinical question or which blood collection tube type should be selected to avoid interferences. Once a patient sample reaches the laboratory and the analyzer, it enters the analytical phase. Therefore, we also cover regulations that guide laboratory testing, the method validation of a new method, the concept of quality control to maintain the accuracy of a test, and commonly employed analytical methods. And finally, after receiving the test result for a patient, we enter the post-analytical phase, where we will learn of the result presentation and what constitutes to a complete laboratory report. We also learn about variables that can contribute to erroneously elevated or decreased patient results. At the end, it's important for everyone involved with the collection, testing, and result interpretation process to not only be able to interpret the test result itself, but also understand the potential sources of error and understand what can go wrong and what can lead to erroneous testing results. Now, if this introduction caught your interest in the field of clinical chemistry, please reach out to the UC Berkeley Extension Program and become part of the laboratory sciences community. Lastly, if you choose to enroll in this program, I wish you a great start into your course.